funny bunny, honey.
Oh, for God's sake, it's you. Oh, geez. I'm gonna need new pants. Hey, those psychos from up north, they've been on the horn, and they're coming down here soon. Now, where is the goddamn money?
Relax, relax. We're not at that part
yet.
Oh,
I thought that you were taking care of this. I really did. And now those Guidos say we gotta do them a favor.
You mean I gotta do them a favor?
Oh, of course that's what I mean. Do I look like I can intimidate a jury? I couldn't intimidate a child, and believe me, I've tried. Now look, it's either that or Ferrelli's cousin Giorgio gets 5 years for fraud. You gotta take these guys out!
I understand. Help the jury change their minds. Don't worry about it.
No! I tried that! The jury case didn't go so well. So make them change their minds.
Hooray, more crap to wipe up. What did I do wrong in a past life?
Some Florida moron.
You're right, boss. Pull out of my way.
And that's supposed to terrify people?
No. We believe passionately in non-violent solutions to life's problems. Gangs have to learn to love, to be inclusionary. We'd award badges to good gangs and give bad gangs a silly hat to wear. It would give people something to feel a part of. Kill with kindness, not a garden tool.
Yes, but what about the guy getting beaten up on the street? Or the man having his motorcycle stolen? What about him?
Or her. Some of the best bikers are really women. Anyone can join our group. This is about poor people getting together.
But your father owns half of Florida. How are you part of the working class?
Like I said,
guilty. Understand? Good.
Oh, man.
Overflowing with wasted potential. Make the guilty men innocent once more. Free them from themselves.
How? How on earth do you do that?
Well, you could let them off.
Marvelous. Great. That's a sensible plan.
Then they wouldn't be guilty anymore.
We've been doing that for years, you idiot. How do you think we'd keep prison costs down? They ain't by magic or cooking the books. We say that for education. But, as in most things, we in government are saving money so that you don't have to. When we spend less money on services, more goes to administration salaries and expenses.
I
don't have any time for you, lame boy.
Come on, get lost.
I can't believe this is happening!
Remember, guilty is a dirty word.
Got no suntan.
We ain't got my money either, so I'm one of them myself. What are you doing? So tell me, what are you doing?
I'm looking for the money, Sonny. Don't worry.
I am worrying, Tommy. That's my style, because I seem to have this problem in my life with unreliable people. Don't be an unreliable person, Tommy. Please, do us both a favor. I'm looking forward to hearing from you.
Get to the payphone next to the mall in Washington.
SBF, I never wear that crap.
Gentlemen, I feel we really got somewhere. And that Vice City and people everywhere know a lot more than they did before we began. And now, over to Jonathan and Melissa to talk to you.
Avery, goes without saying. Tommy, any progress? No. Tell me later. Tommy, this is Avery Carrington. I believe you met at the party.
Not in person.
Howdy.
Avery here has a proposition.
Haven't we got other things on our mind?
I'm trying to keep the wolves from the door. So could you please cut me some slack? I'm stretched like a wire, and even if I'm dead by the end of the week, I'd like to think that I didn't die poor.
Now just calm down, both of you. Son, you help me, and any greaseballs giving you a hard time, I'll see to it they take a long dirt nap.
Okay, what could I do for you?
This delivery company's got its depot on some prime land. They won't sell. They're hanging on like a big old prairie rat. So we gotta go in there and smoke that vermin out. Head on down there and stir up a hornet's nest. The security will have their hands full, and then you can sneak in and put them out of business.
And you could drop by Raphael's for a change of clothes. You might be there a while, but yeah, go for it.
Should be a riot.
If the balls drop like they should, stop by my office sometime.
Who are these pricks anyway? Lawyer pricks, rug-wearing pricks, surrounded by pricks.
The smell says go away.
You have the patience to listen to public radio. Although thanks to the many awards we have won, Pressing Issues has extended playtime and is the number one rated show in the Vice City area. I'm your very entertaining host, Maurice Chavez, a man climbing the broadcasting ladder at a rate of 6 knots. 6 years ago, I was a clown, and now I'm a success. Think about it. Very confusing if you ask me. And you did. And I asked myself, that is a perfect subject for a region-wide discussion show, which is very lucky because I happen to host one. To discuss the subject of morality, we have firebrand preacher Pastor Richards, the head of the Pastor Richards Salvation Statue Organization, a group which plans to raise enough money to build a statue of Pastor Richards himself. We also have John Brown, leader of Moms Against Popular Culture, or MAPC. Or is it MAPS? Map Gay? I don't know. We're deep in acronym hell right now. Or is it purgatory? And finally, we have Barry Stark, author of the book As Nature Intended. He's the editor of Vice City's Naturist News. And
building.